The next speaker has arrived. He's here with me.
Success is no accident.
It is hard work,
perseverance,
learning,
studying,
sacrifice,
and most of all, love of what you are doing.
We have amongst us one such successful person, Mr. S. K. Jha, retired income tax commissioner.
May I now request Dr. G. Gopalakrishnan, director, BI. Balaji Institute of Management and Human Resource Development to felicitate our guest with a bouquet.
Thank you, sir. I request Student Manager Kankana Bora to introduce our guest.
Joy. Success is not final. Failure is not fatal. It is the courage to continue that counts. Good evening, student managers. Today, I, Kankana Bora from BIMM, take immense pleasure to introduce our guest, Mr. S.K. Jha. A calm and a cool man with intelligent eyes and serenity writ large on his face. An income tax commissioner, a lecturer, a voracious reader, a man who can speak for us on any subject under the sun. You put all the things together and what you get, a man of enthusiasm and optimism, Mr. S.K. Jha. Sir has done his MSc in physics and LLB. He was also associated with Indian Revenue Services. He is the former chief commissioner of income tax. Before competing for civil services, he was a lecturer teaching nuclear physics and also a probationary officer with the State Bank of India. He is presently associated with charitable bodies. Sir has mostly worked in Mumbai, partly in Pune, and many other cities. Mr. Jha was also declared as the best investigator in the country and was felicitated by the then finance minister. Sir has also worked for almost 8 years with Income Tax Raid Department in Mumbai, and he has raided many industrialists, companies, and celebrities. Mr. Jha has also won many cases for his department before the High Court and the Supreme Court. Sir, it's an honor to have you amongst us. I hope the student managers sitting over here will make the best out of you. My dear student managers, today, sir is going to speak on the topic, Black Money as a Challenge and its Solutions. Sir, now I would request you to address the audience with your words of wisdom. The podium is all yours, sir. Thank you.
Sir has just gone through a small operation in the leg. So I request you to be seated and then talk.
Good afternoon, my friends. It is love for the students and my regard for Colonel Bala that I am here. In the last 6 months, I have not come out of my house because of a very serious accident. It's a miracle that I'm alive. You see, for the first time, I'm coming out of my house, so you have to excuse me if I'm not very articulate or if I'm a little bit boring. Now, you have just heard very good lectures, which is very good for your career. You will do very well in the career, I'm absolutely sure. But at the end of the day, it is a tax. Tax will not leave you. At the end of the day, today also, this tax man is sitting here. Tax is a difficult thing. The famous scientist Einstein said that I understand everything, but I don't understand tax. It is the most difficult thing on the earth. But anyway, I will not discuss much of the tax. I will discuss something which is of interest to you and interest for the country. Challenges of business, you have heard a lot of many lectures. Now, business doesn't is not a stand-alone concept. Business is a concept which is there in the country, which is there in the international world. If the country does well, business does well. If the business does well, the country does well. So it is interlinked. And for the business, the most important, one very important limb of the business is taxation, tax. And for a country also, taxation system. How important is taxation system? You all are very bright youngsters. You must have heard about the Vodafone case in 2012. Vodafone case came, Supreme Court Vodafone won. The act was amended. Retrospectively, all the FIIs ran away from the country because they said that the country's taxation system is opaque. It is not very good. So taxation system is important. Coming to taxation system, the soul of taxation system is tax. Taxation system moves around tax. I believe you must have be aware how much tax we collect. Total for financial year 15-16, we have collected 14 crore 60 lakhs tax, both direct and indirect together. We are spending 19 lakh crore. So balance is deficit financing, some miscellaneous income, that's all. Now in this context, very important concept is tax GDP ratio. Our tax GDP ratio for our country is 17.7%, which is much less, rather the least in the when the BRIC country. For China, it is 22. Now, I will not go in much in detailing, otherwise it will become boring. Why the tax is low? Why our collection is low? There are two parts of this. One is the tax base. Our tax base is very low. For 128 crore people, Indians, only 5 crore, 43 lakh people have filed income tax return. That comes to about 4%. And the second very big, that is the topic of my discussion today, is the black money. Our income is earned in the country, but it is leaked through the black money. Now, what is black money? All of you know. Still, I will just say, black money is the income on which tax is not paid. The currency note, the 1,000 rupees note is same. If you pay tax, it becomes white. If you don't pay tax, it becomes black. So it is we who make money black. Cutting it short, I will go very important aspect which I have learned. I have learned from my own practical experience. It is not a textbook lecture. This is what I have learned for being 35 years in the Indian Revenue Service. Why there is a tax system? Sorry, why there is a black money? Why there is a black money? I will discuss my things in 3-4 parts. Why there is a black money? You must be having some answers. But the first reason is historical. First reason for the black money is historical. In the pre-independence time, in 1942, there was a Bengal famine. Then there was Second World War. During that time, there was shortage of supply. When there was shortage of supply, many of our businessmen, they started hoarding and selling the goods in the black market. So that was a genesis of the black money. Black marketing, hoarding, and black money. to make it, just give you an example, one very important businessman even today of that time, big, very respected house, he went to Mahatma Gandhi, the father of the nation, and told him, Bapu, I have earned a lot of black money. I am feeling very guilty. I have got a conscience. What do I do? I don't want to name that industry house. It's very respected in the country even today. Bapu said, okay, you spend the money on charity. At least the government will spend money on welfare, you spend the money on the charity. And that he did. Second reason is our tax system, our taxation rate. You will be shocked to know that for 100 rupees earned, there was a time when the tax was 97.50 rupees. There was a time when we had income tax, wealth tax, gift tax, estate duty. If all paid, then a person was paying more than what he had earned. He had to pay even after his death, estate duty. So in that context, naturally nobody will like to pay money out of hard income. So that became a habit formation. I have earned money, why should I pay tax? 97 rupees, 98 rupees. So people start avoiding payment of tax and that becomes black money. Third reason which I feel is that very, very natural in all of us, greed. Greed, we are all very greedy. Let us introspect, we are very greedy. Before I come to this issue, if you have heard of the name of Rajat Gupta, have you heard?
Yes, sir.
He was the one of the top, leading top NRI professional executive, IIT, Harvard, MBA and everything. He was the board member of many best companies in the US and all those things. Just now in the month of March this year, he had been released from jail. He was in jail for 3 years. Why? Despite having so much of money, he wanted to have, out of greed, some more money, and that was black money. And that was insider trading, and he went to jail. So the greed is a very important aspect for hiding our money, hiding our income, and then the black money comes. Third, next is conspicuous consumption. I was in income tax rate department for many years in Bombay. You name the industrialist and I name the film stars whom I have not read. And it was very interesting to see their wardrobes. One industrialist wife, I could see that in the three rooms, there were wardrobes only of the saris and the dresses, one room only for the purse, sandals, all those things. Now, it was very difficult for me to value. I even was wondering, what is the use of so much of things? This is conspicuous consumption out of black money. So there is a tendency for conspicuous consumption. There was one case I had investigated. One young gentleman became very super rich. He made a lot of money in Dubai, came back to India. He wanted to get married. But he wanted to show that I'm very rich. Now how does he show? He decided for the first time in the world, ki I will marry in the sky. The plane was chartered, best hotels were reserved, marriage took place in air. Somebody tried to get married in submarine, but submarine, the government of India didn't give the permission. So, This is called conspicuous consumption, and that requires money. The tax paid white money doesn't suffice that. That's that. So another reason is giving bribes. Somebody told me, ki sir, I was having some inquiry against him. Ki sir, why are you making inquiry? Even Mahatma Gandhi bhi agar hote, to unko bhi bribe dena padta business karne ke liye. Because our country is such that we have to pay bribe to get the work done. From where do I give the bribe? I require cash. So I manipulate my account to bring out the cash. So this is the reason for making the money. My intention is not to earn black money, but I earn black money to give to politicians, to give to the bureaucrats. This is bribe. This bribe is also one reason. Then there are certain properties which you want to buy. Certain properties which you want to buy, which require cash. Even if you are very, very honest, just go and buy land. You will not get land by drawing a check. You require cash. From where do you get the cash? This way, you have to generate black money. Next is that one very important aspect for the black money is the biggest spender in the country, the biggest spender of the money in the country is the government. Rest are all small players. Government spends the maximum money in the country. Unfortunately, the spending of the government is haphazard. It is not well regulated. So money is taken out by the ghost entities. Bogus accounting, bogus billing. In one case which I was instrumental, I can name, there was a very famous scam of the earlier years. You must all have been in school or even was the fodder scam. There was a fodder scam. That was a scam where the bills and vouchers were manipulated. The money meant for the animals were taken out by ghost billing and all those things. I conducted a raid for the first time again in the aircraft. I got an information that money up that point of time, about 1.5 crore was a big amount when I was making the inquiry. So 1.5 crore is being carried out, which has come out from the government treasury. The person of Delhi had gone to Ranchi. The bogus bills were encashed. Bills, the payment was supposed to be for the cows and buffaloes and the goats. That never went. That businessman took the money. I could cash that money. And that was the genesis of the forgery scam. Rest inquiry, that is the history. Even if you have heard, must have heard MNREGA. MNREGA is a big item of expenditure of the country. But many of the beneficiaries are ghost beneficiaries. They don't exist. But money is taken out. So government spends, the payment is in cash, and that cash goes into the ghost. And that ghost, in the hand of the ghost, this money becomes a black money. So the white money of the government becomes the black money in the hand of the ghost. Next reason is our regulation is poor. There is in the US, in United States, the most dreaded department is IRS, Internal Revenue Service. I'm also IRS, Indian Revenue Service, but I'm not that dreaded. Internal Revenue Service in the US has arrested the top celebrities of the US, and all the top politicians and celebrities are scared of IRS. So there's a lack of that much of fear that so that people try to take chance. So that is there are many reasons. Second, I will discuss how the black money is, what is the modus operandi? First, I have said why black money. Why black money is generated? Now I am coming, how the black money is generated? What is the line of action of generating the black money? Before giving the reasons, the most important thing you must understand, maybe a little bit boring, but I can't avoid it. The income is receipt minus expenditure. See, if you want to hide the income, what you do? You hide the receipt, inflate the expenditure. So, by hiding either the receipt or inflating the expenditure, you create black money. Here in Pune, I don't want to name, one of the oldest and the most respected industrialist family of Pune. When I was chief commissioner of Pune, I had done the inquiry. 250 crore, that much of expenses that industrialist had put bogus expenditure. He had created bogus vouchers and claimed bogus expenditure of 250 crores and cash was taken out from the system. That becomes a black money. So you inflate expenditure, you put bogus billing, you hide. Now all of you are going to restaurants to eat something, have snacks and everything. Do you believe that the cash which you pay are not hidden by the business on the shopkeeper? Yes, they are hidden. In fact, they give you bills, but in many cases, the bills are torn off, new bills are prepared for the VAT and for the income tax, and less tax is paid. Another method of creating the black money is very, very common in the top industrialist of this country. I mean, really the top. I can't name, but you can say, you can guess who are the top. One case, what is the modus operandi? Modus operandi starts, because you will all be joining the business houses. The modus operandi starts from when you want to go to the bank for taking loan. You give a project report to the bank. That you ask banker, okay, my project cost is 1,000 crore, you gave me the loan. Chartered accountant signs that. Yes, 1,000 crore, correct. Architect signs, everybody signs. Actual project cost is only 500 crores. It is inflated to 1,000 crore. The banker gives him loan for 1,000 crore directly to the consumer because money doesn't go to the borrower. Money goes to the to the suppliers. And that is all bogus because there are the bogus bills and vouchers are made, cash is taken out, it is only 500 crores. The industrialist who had taken the loan gets 500 rupees cash for the promoters. The persons who issue bills and vouchers, they get some small commission. I know one industrialist whom I had investigated in Bombay. The person who gave bills and voucher for commission is a big steel company itself. And the money collected in cash by the promoters was used through many channels for buying shares of their own company. So money becomes black, and then again it moves around. The starting point again is the project thing. Next is over-invoicing, under-invoicing. You are thinking too much about the money, how the money has gone abroad, where the money is there, who has carried the black money abroad. There is a concept of over-invoicing and under-invoicing. Now, over-invoicing is, suppose this costs 10 rupees, you make a bill for 15 rupees. So the buyer abroad, actually, he was supposed to pay you only 10 rupees, but he was supposed to now give you 15 rupees. From where the 5 rupees comes? This over-invoicing concept was very much popular when the export was tax-free. Money goes from hawala to foreign country. The same money, his own money, he gets back. Opposite to is under-invoicing. So under-invoicing, over-invoicing is a tool to transfer money from here to there. Now question is, how under-invoicing helps? You just make an opposite of that, you will understand. As I told you that giving bribe is one cause for creating black money. The person who takes bribe, the bribe taker, is the main source of the black money, main source of the black money in the country. Then, what is important aspect of the black money is illegal trading. If you are must have read the newspapers recently, there was a drug trafficking in Thane, where 2,000 crore worth of drug business was found. It is interesting because one ex-film heroine was a partner in that, 2,000 crore. Now, if the trading is illegal, entire money becomes black. There is no white in that. Similarly, human trafficking, all those illegal trading. I don't want to go, I will keep my time reserved for question answer, so I'm just going faster. Next is the professionals. You will be shocked to know that many professionals, one very important doctor of the country, I say country, he is based in Mumbai, one of the two, three leading surgeons of the country. Now, the payment to the doctor, if you're operated in the hospital, hospital will pay him by check after deducting tax at source. What does doctor does? I mean, it's very shocking. When the patient is in the operation theater, he calls the people or the patient's attender that you have to pay me extra so much in cash, not through the hospital. Hospital, the bill will come, you will pay. When the patient is in the operation theater, he collects cash. That is a black money. He doesn't show. But this is very shocking. Three times I have raided this doctor, three times. But he was very, very clever. He knew that the tax man will come. But I could not succeed that much, which I had thought. Then the film actors, you all are aware. The film actors, they have got the fixed fee. So much money, producer will pay officially by white money. Over and above, they have to take cash. The cash amount is much higher than the check amount. No top actors and actresses take more than a crore or 2 crore by check. Rest, everything is in cash. There are actors who take 20 crores. So this entire money goes in the cash, so that becomes a black money. Then there are certain assets. As I told you that if you buy certain asset, you have to pay cash. Similarly, when you sell that asset, you get cash. So that cash becomes a black money. There was a trade, the things have much come down now, the builders. When the builders used to sell flats earlier, they used to take a lot of cash. That is all black money. So this is the cause of the black money, how the cause money is being developed. Then there are certain provisions in the Income Tax Act, and even the CSR, which is a new concept, where the Income Tax Department gives the taxpayer benefit that if you do this, your tax will not collect tax. To give an example, there are many research laboratories which are the government of India wants that our country should get more and more research. To having more and more research, the Income Tax Act says if you are doing research and approved by the government, the entire donation is deductible. Rather, more than the donation, 170%, 125%, 175%. So now there are many entities who are doing the money laundering business. They have got a certificate that they are research institutes. They have got registered Section 35. You give a donation to them, they will keep some commission and give you back the cash. Now, the check is being paid by the company. So company's tax will go down and cash will go to the promoter. So promoter has got a windfall income. That entire thing is a black income. So there are the various ways of how the black money is created. Why black money? How black money? Now the third important aspect is, after black money is earned and created, where does it go? This is an important question because all of you must be very interested in Panama Papers. I believe you all must have known Panama Papers. The Panama Papers is an evidence to show how the black money travels, how the black money is hidden. Once the black money is earned in India, there are two, three things happens. One thing is, hide in India. Second thing is, I'll tell you how this is being done. Hide in foreign country. Now, hiding in India, what you do? There was a time our ancestors used to put the money in the pot, put under the ground to hide our money. But now, the simple method is hiding the money, hiding the cash in the bank lockers. Hiding the money in the many bank accounts, very many names which are bogus. So you can hide the money in India like this. There was a case, you will be shocked to know that is not possible now, the act has changed. The 150 crores, I think 20 years back, 150 crore was deposited in the bank account of a dancing girl who didn't have any place of her own stay. So these are the bogus names in which the cash is deposited. So this is the way of hiding. Then the method of hiding is you buy jewelry, buy things, buy costly items. You hide by buying the costly stuff. And how you hide abroad? You send the money. There is a system called hawala. Hawala means you give the cash to somebody in India. The equal money that person, his agent will give you abroad. That money goes abroad, and then you hide the money in some foreign companies, foreign cell companies. So just to give an example, Vijay Mallya has run away, all of you know. Now, where does he live? Living in Vijay Mallya in London, he is in the countryside of London, about 30, 40 kilometers away from London. His mansion has got 25 acres of compound. Vijay Mallya's mansion near London, 25 acres of compound, massive mansion. Name of the mansion is Lady Walk. Now, who is the owner of Lady Walk? Nobody knows. After some small investigation, it was found that is being held in the name of some cell company. Some company whose owner is not clear. Cell company is a legal entity. Who are the persons behind that cell company? Nobody knows. Panama Papers has said the same thing. Panama Papers has said that cell companies are created abroad to hide your money. You invest the money abroad in properties and things in your conspicuous consumption, but nobody knows who is the real owner of that cell company. That is called Panama Papers disclosure. Now, Cayman Island is one of the very important tax haven. Important tax haven, I say, because it has population of 40,000. Or there are 80,000 companies registered in Cayman Island. Population 40,000, companies 80,000. So this, and there's a research by California University that 8% of the resources of the world are there in the tax haven countries. So these are the resting ground of our black money. Once the black money is earned, how we keep in India, how we keep abroad. Now, people are not satisfied only by keeping the money and hiding it. The other way out also. They will like to bring some black money back to the business. In India, there is one method. Coming from outside India, there is another method. Now, if your black money is abroad, then how do you bring to India? You bring to India through routes like from Mauritius, from Singapore. We have got tax avoidance treaty. Recently, the Mauritius route has been closed. Some amendment has come in the agreement. How this happens? The money, the black money goes out, then it comes to India through participatory notes. Have you heard participatory notes? Yeah. The participatory notes, nobody knows who the real owner behind that. The FIIs are having the participatory note, they are holders of participatory note, they invest in the share market. That's one way. They sell the money, they again goes back to the foreign country. For Mauritius route, the capital gain tax is very small. And in India, capital gains tax was heavy. So people want to buy the property here, sell it, money comes from Mauritius. So as per double taxation agreement, capital gain will be taxed in Mauritius, so there was no capital gain. Now these are the small methods of. I have got only 10 minutes. I have been given notice that only 10 minutes I have to speak, so I will go hurriedly. Now, what is the effect of black money? One very bad effect of the black money is that our country's resources are reduced. The money on which we should have got tax, that money is lost. So the government of India doesn't have big money to spend on development. So one very big impact, bad impact of black money is resources of the country. Second is inflation. Because the black money, the more money in the market, changing goods, so there will be inflation. The second aspect. Third aspect of the black money impact is economic inequality. Now, if you have earned a lot of black money, you become very rich. The poor man who has paid tax, he remains poor. So he remains poor. See, economic inequality because of black money. Next is social immorality. With lot of black money, the morality of the society goes down. You do lot of bad things, which you could not have done with your tax-paid white income. Now, if you have got lot of black money, you do lot of immoral things. You spend lot of things on the things which you would not have done normally. So our morality goes down. I have written an article sometime back in the Corporate Citizen here magazine. When I was conducting a search, the man of the house told me, "You search everything, but don't search my briefcase before my wife." And the wife said the same thing, "Search everything, take everything, but don't search my personal cupboard before my husband." There are a lot of things to hide from each other. Because the black money brings our morale down. They do a lot of dirty things. With small money and white money, you would not have dared to do that. So these are the very, very bad aspects of the bad thing. Now comes the last issue. If this is such a problem, how do we solve the black money problem? The most important thing to solve the black money, this is not an easy formula. Even the government of India doesn't have the easy formula. Otherwise, there won't have been so much of black money. The first thing is that we have to make our tax system simple and effective. Simple that everybody should understand. We should not be in the hands of the tax advocates. And effective, if somebody has gone wrong, he should be punished. There should be some deterrent punishment. Unless there's a fear in the mind of the people, the black money will keep on growing. Second thing, you must have heard that there is a department called IB. IB collects intelligence about what is happening in the country, say, like terrorists and all those things. So there should be some institution like IB to collect information from the market about the black money. Recently, Government of India had done a very important thing and a good thing. In 10 countries, Income Tax Department has issued offices in 10 countries, and they are sending information from those 10 countries. So informations are coming. Then there is a tax information exchange service which Government of India has entered into various countries, as per which black money information comes to us. So there are many things, like we give reward to the informants. We have to improve the rewards to give to the informant. There is no black and white method, but there are many methods. It's a big issue and big topic. So I will like, because the time constraint is there, I will like that you should ask if you have got any question. The black money is the creation of ourselves. There is no difference between black money and white money unless it is tax paid or not paid. If you have got any question, I'll feel happy answering your question.
Good evening, sir. Hello. Sir, this on your left, sir.
Hello, sir.
Tell me.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Sir, is there any tax system running for temple donations in the temple? If no, then is there any body which regulates the tax where that money is going to from the temple?
I couldn't get your. I couldn't hear properly whatever you have said. It's not very clear, coming clearly to me.
Okay. Sir, mandiron mein jo donation hota hai, sir, uske liye koi tax system hai kya Bharat mein? और कि वो टैक्स वो पैसा कहाँ जा रहा है उसके उसको रेगुलेट करने के लिए कोई बॉडी है क्या?
नहीं ना क्वेश्चन इज व्हाटएवर व्हाट इज द जॉब ऑफ द इनकम टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट. जॉब ऑफ द इनकम टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट इज टू इन्वेस्टिगेट एंड कलेक्ट द करेक्ट टैक्सेस. नाउ द इफ द ब्लैक मनी इज मूविंग इफ इट इज नॉट कॉट आवर जॉब इट्स अ डिपार्टमेंट्स जॉब टू इन्वेस्टिगेट एंड कैच हिम एंड रेज द टैक्स. If I'm able to understand your question, so it is law, income tax law says that. There is a new law has come, Black Money Act. Now, Black Money Act deals with the black money abroad. If some black money is caught abroad, then total tax plus penalty is 120% plus jail. You can be sent to jail plus 120% tax and penalty. So I'm telling you that there is a failure. There is a greed in the people But there is failure from the income tax department also. Had there been no failure, they wouldn't have been any blackmail. So our department is such that it is constrained with manpower. It is has got difficulty of infrastructure. Now I'll just give you an example. I was sent to I was sent to Canada by Government of India. There was no computer in the income tax department. So we, I was with, this was my good luck that I represented Government of India to have an agreement with Government of Canada for computerization of the income tax department. Now with computerization coming, we are able to, we are becoming more intellectual, more savvy. Now there are other ways, as you said, we are getting information from various, we are getting information from various entities. Whatever money you put in the bank today, if your money, you deposit more than 10 lakh cash in your savings account, I get your name and address. If you are withdrawing from credit card more than 2 lakhs of rupees in a year, we get the information. If you are buying property for more than 30 lakhs, we get the information. So all these information, if you transact in the share mutual fund, more than 2 lakhs, we get the information. These informations are collected and then we act on that. I was just talking earlier that 7 lakh notices have been issued to all the high transactions where people have not paid taxes, 7 lakh notices. So it is very difficult job. I say that black money is a parallel economy. Unfortunately, it started from the pre-independence days, it has continued to continue. As on today, our tax rate is very, very moderate. Tax rate is very moderate, but still our habit is formed of not paying proper tax. So that is there, but government is now, we are conducting raids and we are getting 500 crore. In one case, we have got 500 crore cash recently at one place. And 500 crore cash at one place. Tell me.
Sir, my question to you is, recently, Bala Subramanian Swami.
Yeah, the mic is not very clear.
Hello.
Because
Subramanian Swami has made a statement that India should abolish income tax in order to increase the savings rate and in order to get the black money. So what is your view on that?
I will stand up and then I'll hear properly. Because I'm not able to understand. Yes.
What is your view on that?
I'll tell you. That is a very good question. In the tax haven countries, there is no income tax. So there is no black and white. So if there is no income tax, there is no black money. Very good question. But question is the income tax is abolished? And we are a big country. If income tax is abolished, from where do we get the money? I told you right from the beginning that total government of India gets 14 lakh crore from tax, both direct and indirect. Direct come tax is major share, indirect tax is less share. Our expenditure is 19 lakh crore, very, very less. Balance is our deficit financing. So if we don't get income tax, from where we'll make the roads and bridges? Even today, I'm really sorry to say, when the finance minister is saying, in a very sad way, that in the last 2 years, the private sector has not come out very openly to invest money in the market. They're still suffering from the past losses or something, whatever. It is the government of India which is spending money. Otherwise, we will not get the jobs, employment. So you require money. The most important thing is you require money. In a small country like Singapore, and in Singapore also, there is a small tax, less tax, 15% tax is there. But the population of Singapore, I was just telling, is same as population of Pune, same population. In a small country, this is possible. So how is it possible they become a tax haven? So people, money from all over the world, they come there. Now, do you want India to become a tax haven country? It cannot. We are a very idealistic country. We can't become tax haven. And tax haven, we will not be able to do much. We are the third biggest power agent today, economically. So we have to go far away. We have, the only solution lies that we have to increase our tax. And for increasing our tax, there are two things. Our black money has to go, and our tax base has to increase. Just believe 128 crore people, only 5 lakhs paying tax. And out of 5 lakhs, you will be shocked to know that 470,000 are the salaried employee and the small people. Only 40,000 people in the country, only 40,000 people in the country are paying, showing income more than 10 lakhs. This is a very sad thing. And one more sad thing is, our farmers are dying, you know all. Our farmers are poor, you know. But you will be shocked to know that about 6,000 farmers in 3 years have disclosed income more than a crore per farmer. From where this 1 crore has come? It's all black money being out. So farmer is just a name lender. So a rich man is there behind that farmer, and he disclosed making it white. So this is a big, black money is a big problem, absolutely big problem. Now Swiss, earlier we used to think that our money is lying in a Swiss bank. Swiss bank, our money had really gone down. Now our money is in the other tax haven countries. Okay, recently I was reading the article that only 8,000 crore and 9,000 crore is the Indian's money is there in a Swiss bank. Okay, so we require money. There is, I'm telling you very frankly, I was really pained because you are all business managers. I was really pained, and the country was getting pained. Our big business houses had lost trust in our own country, and they were investing outside India. All big business houses of our country, they were starting factories and all outside India. They didn't have trust in India. But things are reverting. But they have lost money outside India. Tata Steel has lost a lot of money outside India. Now they are selling the company there. So we have to invest money in India. We have to generate money in India. We have to make India really powerful. China is 5 times our country in GDP and all those things. So we have to increase tax. There is no way out.
Thank you, sir, for taking out time and coming here for us. We feel fortunate. Your practical insights on the taxation system, black money, and reasons why black money exists will prove to be valuable to us in our lives.
May I now request Professor Dr. Archana Srivastav, Director in Charge, BIMM, to present our guest with a token of our appreciation.
Thank you very much. My best wishes and blessings. You earn a lot of money. And you get any help, I'm at your disposal.